Greetings, this is another video mini review by the flashlight reviewer Selfbuilt. Today I'm looking at a new updated head for the Crelant 7G5 version 2. This is the high output thrower light from Crelant, single emitter. This is an aspheric or collimator head. It's designed to collimate the light and put it out into more defined beam. Basically, it's an aspheric shaped lens that focuses the light, so instead of using a reflector. There's another of popular lights out there that use aspherics of various sizes. It tends to give you more throw, but at the expense of spill and at the expense of a smooth beam. What it basically does is it projects an image of the die at a distance. And since the die is not uniform, you'll see things like the bond wires and the shape of the die. You'll also see some color aberration across the edges of or fringing around the edge of the emitter die. And of course, it'll make a very square hotspot instead of a round one. But it's an option to get a lot more throw. So this head, actually I might as well just start by showing you a bit about the head, is interesting. You can see there, I focus it around a little bit, move it around, you can see that there's an aspherical, so round, kind of like a convex lens, but only on one side underneath that glass lens. That's a little different. If I show you like a classic aspheric, like here's the DBS light from Dyrolite, you can see the big kind of ball right there that is the aspheric glass lens. In this case, there's another glass lens on top, I guess to protect the aspheric. Also allows tail standing, head standing in this case. And you can see the aspheric is underneath. The light comes with a little screw-in cover to protect the inside. So there's the inside of the aspheric. And it screws on to, as I said, the 7G5 version 2. Note only the version 2 model, not the original version 1, which had another different physical build. So the way this works is you just unscrew the head from the emitter pill area. So there's the reflector version head. And you just screw on instead where the threads mat exactly. The new collimator or aspheric head. Turn it all the way there, and it works as before. I'll turn it on. You can get the idea that that's a fairly square-looking beam as I move it up. You can see it looks a little round on the picture. It's actually not quite like that in real life. Let's see if we can move it down to. I might as well leave it on high. Gives you the best pattern. Maybe low. Let's see how that looks. And when you get it out, you get the idea that this is a very restricted pattern sort of head. You do have to usually play a bit with the focusing. You can unscrew the head a little bit to adjust for the focus, although in this case I find pretty much full tight actually works almost best for peak focus for mine. You'll see detailed specs on my review comparing it to the standard smooth reflector head, as well as other typical aspherics like the Dyrolite or the Diablo A9, which are very common on candle power forms. Obviously this is a very large aspheric, but it's also using a larger emitter, the XML emitter. And the larger the emitter die, the less well things typically throw under aspherics. So that's part of the reason why they need the larger one, I think, to get a reasonably good throw with the aspheric head. But you're really best just to check out my full review for more details on how it performs, including outdoor beam shots, which you will find at Candle Power Forms in the review form under the username Selfbuilt, or my personal website at flashlightreviews.ca. Thanks, and I hope you found that helpful. Also, don't forget to check out my full review and video review for more information about the 7G5 version 2 light in its original form with smooth reflector. Thanks a lot.